Hello everybody, this is my how to cook sockeye salmon video. This is my bag of salmon here. I take one fillet and I cut it in half and put it in the bag. I put paper towels around the fish, and that way it helps prevent freezer burn down the road. So let's get this puppy opened up. So here we have our salmon. See, I put cellophane around the one, wrapped in paper towels. It just helps prevent freezer burn down the road. Take the paper towels off. Everything's good. And there's your fillet right there. So there's our fillet. And you'll notice that right here, if we get really close in here, you can kind of see these little white bones that are right across in here. And you can take your finger and you can rub them across right there, and you can feel those bones and you can see them. They're normally not from here on back. That's why I cut my fillet right there. So what you're going to do is you're going to take a pair of tweezers or some fish pliers or something that's clean, and you're just going to reach in there and you're going to grab those bones. And just pull them right out. So I got my fish pliers here, and I'm just going to reach in and I'm going to grab that bone and just pull it right out. You pull that bone right out of there. You're just going to take your pliers and you're going to go in there and grab that little bone and just pull it right out. So you're just taking those little bones right out of there. There's normally about 40 of them in there, but you can go through and pull these bones out. If you have any question at any time whether you hit a bone or not, you can take your fingers and rub it on there and you would feel that bone sticking out, just like that one right there. And they come out pretty easy. You pull it from the back to the front. Take your fingers and just feel right along there. You can feel if there's any bones left, and you get them all out, you're done. So there's your fillet. Just double check that, make sure there are no bones in there. That's good, looks good. Next thing I like to do is I like to take my fillet and you don't want to cut all the way through the skin, you just want to cut the meat and go across hatching just like this. Same thing on the back half. No bones in this back half. So now when you pick up your fillet, you can actually take it and open it up like this. Get all those little things of meat that are open. Then you can take, I like to use any type of seasoning that you want to use is good. I like the complete, it's got everything in it. I just take your fish and you just sprinkle this into all the crevices. Same thing with the back half. Okay. we're ready for the barbecue. Now we're gonna fire up the barbecue here. We're gonna let that cook down. Just to go talk about the other part of our seasoning. Now for the seasoning, I like to take a cup and I'll put some brown sugar in there. Use the last of the brown sugar that I had. I'd normally put about a half a cup of brown sugar in there. Take some more of my seasonings and put them in here. Just like that. I like to take and put a little bit of honey in there for my moisture. Take a fork and mix that all up until it's a nice little slurry of a sauce. Try not to add any water to it if you don't have to. This will normally be all you need. Just that brown sugar, seasonings, a little bit of honey in there for the moisture. Mix that up really good. Now if your clump gets too clumpy like this, you can take and you can add a little bit of water to it. Doesn't take a lot. Does not take a lot of water at all. You don't want it too watery. You just want it kind of a nice, like gravy, kind of thick. Talk a little bit about this sauce here when I start putting it on the fish. So you can see my sauce now is just kind of a thick paste. That's what I want. Then I like to take a little bit of pineapple juice or some type of a citrus juice, and I'll put just a little bit in there. Perfect sauce. Now about this point, I like to take my fillets and I'll put them in a little container and I'll put a little bit of juice on top of them too. It doesn't take a lot. Remember, you've cut your fish. Put the other fillet in there on top of it. Just let it soak, let it brine in these juices while you're barbecue is heating up. You got your sauce all lined up. Now we'll start cooking the fish. Our charcoals are getting close. Time to put the fish on. Just before I throw the fish on the grill, I like to take it and open it up, and I've chosen a little bit of mesquite today. I'm going to put some mesquite on it. Get it all down there in the cracks. Now the great thing about fish skin is it acts as a protective barrier between the grill and the meat. So I like to take the fish and I just put the skin side down right on the coal, right on the grill. Just like that. And the skin will take all the torment from the fire, but it won't burn your fish meat. You can cook the heck out of it if you want. So we're going to notice a couple of cooking steps for the fish. Right now we see there's no white oils coming out. Eventually we will see the white oils coming out. Some people don't like to cook it that much. They like their meat wet. I like mine dry. Well, relatively. So I cook it until the oils come out, which normally if there's any bad stuff in the fish, it'll come out with those oils. And then when we put our sauces back on, the meat will soak that back into it. So we'll follow that here. Now I've decided that I'm gonna smoke my fish a little bit. I like to use cottonwood bark. So I'm just gonna open this up a little bit here. Just like so. Put the cottonwood bark on there. Adds a little bit of a nice flavor to it. I really like it. We get our water bottle and we'll spray that occasionally if it catches on fire. Till then, we're just gonna let her cook. Let's check it out. Oh yeah, we can kind of see those white oils are starting to come out around the edges. But we want it to come out of all up here too. So we're looking good. Just gonna spray that piece of wood right there a little bit. Looking good, right where we need to be. Not quite yet. Let's go ahead and check our fish here. Oh yeah, looking mighty good. We can kind of see how the white oils are starting to come up. So I'll take a brush. I just kind of brush that off. You can see that fish skin's taking quite a licking, but that's okay. That's what it's there for. And I just take my sauce, start dribbling it on the fish a little bit. Make sure I get it down in those cracks. Same thing can be done in the oven. Takes about 30 to 35 minutes at 350 to cook it in the oven, doing the same things. I just like to barbecue it if I can. Put our first coating of sauce on there. Looking mighty good. Go ahead and close her up and let her cook a little bit more. So far the grilling time on the barbecue has been about 20 minutes. Normally takes about 30 to 35 minutes to cook. So we'll check on it again here in a minute and sauce it up one more time. I'm back here again doing the second saucing up. Getting pretty close. Letting those juices just cook in. You kind of see them just cooking right in there. Okay, it's been about half an hour and you can kind of see the white oils are kind of dissipating. Gonna brush it one more time, let it cook for about 5 more minutes, and then we'll top it off with the final ingredient. You can kind of see how these oils are all cooking out and they're starting to dissipate now. That's what we want. Okay, it's been about 30-35 minutes, really done. That's good. Now our last ingredient is going to be honey. What I like to do is I like to put honey on the top of the fish, because what that does is that heats up, and then when you pull it off, it just kind of binds all the seasonings in with the fish. Put that honey on there. We're gonna let that cook for about 2 minutes and then get ready to pull her off. And we're looking good. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna take our spatula and go right between the skin and the meat. Then just lift the meat right off of the skin.
Mike.
And pulling the fish off. And just leave the skin right on the grill. This is my favorite, the belly meat. So when you're done, all you're left with is the fish skin on the grill. And that'll come off later when it's all cooled off. Or you can take it off now, but it's better just to let it cool down and pull it off a little later. It's up to you, whatever you want, but it just comes off in one piece, see? Then I like to take the fish and just kind of break it up a little bit. Kind of break it up just a little bit, just like that. Then I take a little bit more honey. And there you go. Wild caught Alaska sockeye salmon grilled with brown sugar seasonings and honey and cottonwood smoke. Remember, you can do the same thing in the oven at about 350. It takes about 30 to 35 minutes to cook your salmon. Just brush the oils off and put the other seasonings on that you want and top it off at the end with some honey. Enjoy.